Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Wednesday, the Feast of Saint Martha. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Jesus entered a village where a woman named Martha welcomed him into her home.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, whose Son was pleased to be welcomed in St. Martha's house as a guest, grant, we pray, that through her intercession, serving Christ faithfully in our brothers and sisters, we may merit to be received by you in the halls of heaven. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Woe to me, mother, that you gave me birth, a man of strife and contention to all the land. I neither borrow nor lend, yet all curse me. When I found your words, I devoured them. They became my joy and the happiness of my heart, because I bore your name, O Lord, God of hosts. I did not sit celebrating in the circle of merrymakers. Under the weight of your hand, I sat alone because you filled me with indignation. Why is my pain continuous, my wound incurable, refusing to be healed? You have indeed become for me a treacherous brook whose waters do not abide. Thus the Lord answered me, if you repent so that I restore you, in my presence you shall stand. If you bring forth the precious without the vial, you shall be my mouthpiece. Then it shall be they who turn to you, and you shall not turn to them. And I will make you toward this people a solid wall of brass. Though they fight against you, they shall not prevail, for I am with you, to deliver and rescue you, says the Lord. I will free you from the hand of the wicked and rescue you from the grasp of the violent. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let our response be, God is my refuge on the day of distress.
God is my refuge on the day of distress.
Rescue me from my enemies, O my God. From my adversaries, defend me. Rescue me from evildoers. From bloodthirsty men, save me.
God is my refuge on the day of distress.
For behold, they lie in wait for my life. Mighty men come together against me, not for any offense or sin of mine, O Lord.
God is my refuge on the day of distress.
O my strength, for you I watch. For you, O God, are my stronghold. As for my God, may his mercy go before me. May he show me the fall of my foes.
God is my refuge on the day of distress.
But I will sing of your strength and revel at dawn in your mercy. You have been my stronghold, my refuge in the day of distress.
God is my refuge on the day of distress.
O my strength, your praise will I sing. For you, O God, are my stronghold, my merciful God.
God is my refuge on the day of distress. Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to comfort them about their brother Lazarus, who had died. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went to meet him, but Mary sat at home. Martha said to Jesus, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you. Jesus said to her, your brother will rise. Martha said to him, I know he will rise in the resurrection on the last day. Jesus told her, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And anyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? She said to him, Yes, Lord, I have come to believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Ngayong araw, pinagdiriwang natin yung kapistahan ni Santa Martha. No? Kilala natin siya, di ba? Magkakapatid sila na si Martha, si Mary, at si Lazarus. So, supposedly, malapit sila sa Panginoon. No? They were very, very good friends of the Lord. No? And when you think of Martha and Mary, you think of two principles of our spirituality. No? Martha is the active principle, and Mary is the contemplative principle, the prayerful one. But let us reflect on Martha today, today being the Feast of Martha. Tingnan natin yung, para kumbaga yung pagtubo or the growth and development of Martha's spirituality, yung pagtubo at pagunlad ng kanyang spirituality or kanyang relationship sa Panginoon, no? Ngayon, yung nakita natin ngayon, ito yung raising of Lazarus, no? But prior to this, isang pagdalaw ng Panginoon sa kanila, di ba nagreklamo si Martha? Because Martha was busy serving the Jesus, and then she complained to the Lord that Mary was not helping her. And remember what the Lord told Martha. She said, "Martha, Martha, masyado kang abala, di ba, with so many things. But Mary had chosen the better part, no? That Mary had chosen to sit at the foot of Christ, the prayer and contemplation." Hindi naman pinagalitan ng Panginoon si Martha at that time, no? But she was trying to tell her na mahalaga rin yung napili ni Mary, no? And then later on, fast forward, so to speak, you have now the raising of Lazarus, no? And Christ visits Martha and Mary. And kung mapansin ninyo, parang ang laki nung paglalim ng pananampalataya ni Martha. Because Martha was one of the first in Scripture to confess the resurrection or to say that you are the Christ, no? And I believe in the resurrection. And for me, that is a very powerful symbol, symbol of how Martha grew in her own spirituality, how she was able to integrate with her active life, no? That sense of contemplation, for her to understand that Jesus is the Christ and Jesus will bring the resurrection of the dead. When you think about it, this gospel for today really brings us to the core of our Christian faith. And the core of that Christian faith is that life will not end in death, and that ang kahulugan ng buhay natin ay nagbabago. Dahil alam natin na lahat ng ating pagsisikap ngayon, lahat ng ating paghihirap, lahat ng ating pagpupursige, hindi siya magtatapos sa kamatayan because of the resurrection. Dahil muling nabuhay ang Panginoon, na hindi ang kamatayan ang kahahantungan ng lahat ng pinagpapaguran natin at pinaghihirapan natin sa buhay na ito. That everything in our life now assumes a different meaning precisely because we have eternity as our horizon. We have resurrection, the resurrection as really the end goal, the horizon of our lives. And for me, that's very, very powerful. Kaya meron kang mga martir, meron kang mga bayani, kasi handa silang magbuwis ng buhay sa kanilang pinaniniwalaan at sa kanilang pinaninindigan. And I think Martha is also, no, in a sense, she is the synthesis of this. She is the synthesis of active service, and yet rooted and grounded in that faith that everything that she works for, the ultimate meaning is the resurrection. And for us, that is very important now. As we face many challenges because of this pandemic and because of the situation in the world and in our country, I think it is important for us to renew our faith like Martha, that life will not end in death, that all of these have a greater meaning because of the resurrection. And this is Martha's growth in her spirituality, in her relationship with the Lord. Diba? Simula dun sa nagreklamo siya dahil hindi siya tinutulungan ni Mary sa pagsisilbi sa kanya, sa Panginoon at sa mga bisita, Tapos dito naman, di ba, nung sa panahon ng krisis, nung namatay ang kapatid nilang si Lazarus, siya yung sumalubong sa Panginoon. At noong nag-uusap sila tungkol sa kamatayan ni Lazarus, doon pinakita ni Mary, ni Martha, yung kalaliman ng kanyang pananampalataya. Yung kanyang pagtubo at pag-unlad ng kanyang relationship sa Diyos at sa Panginoong Hesukristo. You are the resurrection. And I think that is really the game changer of our lives as Christians. That we know that everything we work for, the horizon is eternity. The horizon is the resurrection. And let me go into a final and third point. There is another, the next chapter, this is, we read from John 11. In John 12, again, Jesus visits the home of Lazarus, Martha, and Mary in Bethany. And this, remember, this is immediately before the Passion of our Lord. And remember, yung sa scene naman yon, Mary now anoints the feet of Christ with very, very expensive oil, no? And there's only one word that describes Martha in that chapter. You read the next chapter, chapter 12 of John. It simply says there, as this was going on, you know, the Mary washing the feet of Christ with very expensive oil, and there's only one word that describes Martha in the midst of all that. Martha served. And for me, that is, again, the testament to the spirituality of Martha and the testament to our spirituality as Christians that we serve. Martha was consistently the one who served and was the active principal. But given the gospel for today, you realize that this service now comes from the faith of the risen Lord, faith in the risen Lord. And today we pray for that. Let us pray that we may be contemplatives in action, like Martha and Mary. But Martha was able to synthesize that. She grew in her contemplation to be able to see and to realize that Jesus is the Messiah, and that the resurrection is the horizon of our lives. And thus, her service was within that horizon. And I pray today that we may also be within that horizon of eternity as we dedicate our lives to service. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. On this feast of Saint Martha, let us remember those persons who serve us daily, and let us ask God to grant them the blessings and graces they deserve. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who work in the service of the church may truly become contemplatives in action, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That public servants may perform their duties in the spirit of love and service, especially amidst during the virus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That like Martha, may we be willing and generous in bringing joy and comfort to those entrusted to our care. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick, especially those affected by the virus, and the aged, may find care and support from their family and friends. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed, and especially those who have died due to the virus, who served in this life, may reap the fruits of their labors in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And together also we ask you to join us in praying for ABS and we pray especially for those who have been retrenched and their families. So together we invite you to pray with us the Kapamilya prayer.
Father in heaven, watch over us, our ABS-CBN family, all our employees, our leaders, friends, and supporters, Kapamilyas all. Grant us the grace to feel more deeply your presence in all that we are going through now. Experience more powerfully your loving providence. Saint Joseph, you believed in your dreams that made it possible for your son to fulfill his mission, our salvation. Make us continue to believe in our dreams and in one another. Please care for us, especially our Kapamilyas affected by the retrenchment, as you cared for Jesus and Mary. Blessed Mother, in our moment of need, place us with your Son, and may we do whatever he tells us. Embrace us, most especially our affected kapamilyas, with your motherly protection. Come, Lord Jesus, in the midst of our challenges, and lead us along the path of the mission you have called us to be in the service of the Filipino. Our confidence and hope is in you alone, and in your eternal assurance that in the tender mercy of our God, by which the rising sun will come to us from heaven, to shine on those living in darkness and in the shadow of death, to guide our feet into the path of peace, we shall overcome. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, to your goodness. We have this bread and this wine to offer, fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands. They will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we proclaim your wonders in St. Martha, O Lord, we humbly implore your majesty that as her homage of love was pleasing to you, so too our dutiful service may find favor in your sight through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure signs of your love, and that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled. Their great example lends us courage. Their fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. We remember especially our brothers and sisters who passed away because of this virus. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with Saint Martha, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you were present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them and grant eternal rest to those who have died. Grant us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We ask for your special providence and protection for the whole world and humanity, our country and our people, our families and our friends. Send your spirit to protect us from this virus. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us.
And let us pray. May the holy reception of the body and blood of your only begotten Son, O Lord, turn us away from the cares of this fallen world, so that following the example of Saint Martha, we may grow in sincere love for you on earth and rejoice to behold you for eternity in heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.